Hey everyone, it's Nick Valenti with NJ Valenti Art, and in today's video I'm going to show you my illustration workflow in Affinity Designer. What I love about Affinity Designer is it is truly an all-in-one program. Unlike Adobe products where you would have to sketch in Photoshop and have to then bring it over to Illustrator to Vector, we can do all of that right here in Affinity Designer seamlessly. To create a new document, I'm going to come up here to New. I have a 16 by 20 preset in here. I'm going to stick with that one for now. So it's 16 by 20 at 300 DPI. I'm going to make this one a landscape. I also want to scroll down and I want to click on transparent background. And I will go ahead and create. One of the first things I like to do is while I'm still in the design persona here is I will create a vector layer and simply grab this square tool. I'm going to kill the stroke on that and come over here and select a nice white. And this will be my base background layer of pure white here. Go ahead and lock that. On the upper left, you could see our three main features here. We have the designer persona, which has all of our vector tools. The pixel persona, where we can work on our drawing or sketches. And finally, the export persona, where we have a full control over the types of files we can export. This video really is a basic overview of these personas. There's a lot to each that deserves its own video, but this will give you a good idea of how I use Affinity Designer to create my artwork. Let's start with the pixel persona so we can make our drawing before moving to vector. I have a video with a breakdown on the pixel persona for sketching, and you can find that in the description below. I'm going to go ahead and start a new pixel layer, which will be the paper icon here with the checkerboard pattern. Let's drag this on top of my current vector layer that I'm using as my white background. I'm going to select our brush tool and turn on the symmetry mode. At this point, holding shift as I get close to vertical, it'll snap it in place there. And I will click on mirror and lock that guide in place. Come up here and select my pencil brush. I'm gonna get started on this drawing and speed things up here a little bit. In order to merge two layers in the pixel persona, you want to group both of the layers. So clicking on one and clicking on the other, holding shift. And then if we right click, we can group the layers. Once we have the layers grouped, if we right click again, come up here to rasterize, it will now merge both of those layers together, creating one pixel layer here. Now that we have our drawing, we can come up here to the upper left and we'll select the design persona. So we want to create a new vector layer and we can start our vector inking process. And to create the vector inking layer, we'll come down here and we'll see this paper icon with the bent corner that says add layer. This will be a vector layer. So go ahead and click that to add layer. And I do want to make sure that that layer is above our pixel art layer. And we can come in here and we can come to the pixel layer and we can lower the opacity on the layer, make it a little bit easier to see our ink lines. Or, if you'd like, you can also come up to, if we leave that on full opacity for the pixel layer, come up here to Effects, and we'll scroll down to Color Overlay. We'll click on this black rectangle here, and we'll move the color to a light blue or turquoise. So that is an option as well. You can use the Color Overlay in the Effects panel here on the pixel layer if you want to create blue lines to ink over instead of just the gray pencil lines. We also want to name our layers and lock whatever layers we are not working on. So this one here, we can call this the butterfly sketch. And with this layer selected, if I come up here to this little lock icon, it says lock, unlock. And if I click it once, it'll lock that layer. It's totally worth the little extra time to set up in order to stay organized, especially as our illustration becomes more complicated. Now we can select our pen tool and start our vector inking. I have a video that covers my vector inking approach in Affinity Designer, stroke versus fill, and I'll have a link to that in the description below. For this one here, I think using a stroke line will work best, so let's get to inking. Once I have finished one half of my vector lines, I will now select all of the lines. And holding Alt to duplicate and Shift at the same time to drag it in place. So we want to come over here, we'll drag it over, come up here to the top and flip horizontal. Continuing to hold Shift, we'll drag it over to keep it in line. And once we get to a place that looks pretty good, let me scoot it back over to the left here just a bit. Yeah, so once we get it to a place that looks pretty good, we can come in here and then start cleaning up any of our connecting points down the middle if we need to. But these look all pretty good right here. I'm now going to lock our inks layer and create a new vector layer under the inks. And I'm going to name this for our color layer, so butterfly colors. And we can get started on our coloring process. All right, so I'm actually going to come back into our inks layer up here. What I actually want to do is I want to go ahead and just grab each one of these inner pieces. I've got a different idea for these. I'm going to move these to the color layer. And I'm going to end up getting rid of the black outline here and going with just a solid fill color. So go ahead and bring these down to our color layer. And then what I could go ahead and do in the inks layer again is select these on the right side, which we've already duplicated, and we'll just delete these since we'll be filling them in on the right side in a different color and then bringing it over with the rest of our colors. I like using gradients as a base layer for my colors. I actually have a video on using gradients, and I'll have a link to that in the description below. Here in the colors, I'm going to go ahead and select our main colors for the wings, holding Alt to duplicate and Shift to drag. I'll flip that horizontal, continuing to hold Shift and drag this over. See, I grabbed an extra eyepiece here, so I can go ahead and delete that. All right, so what we can go ahead and do now is we'll go ahead and turn off our pixel layer, so we're left with just our vector inks and colors. I'll come down to our base layer here, the white layer that we're using as our background, and I'm going to do just set a simple gradient background here, just to add a little dimension and depth to the piece. So I think this works here for our purposes. Once we are happy with our illustration, it is time to export, so we can either post it or send it to our client. And we'll come up here to the export persona. On the left side here, we have several tools. We have a slice tool, slice selection tool, which would be for breaking up individual assets of the piece to export individually. We also have the view tool and our zoom tool. Since we want to export the whole image for the most part, we can just focus on our export options here. These options will allow us to export either finished, fully rasterized files, or to export as fully editable working files. So we have our PNG and JPEG options here, GIFs and TIFFs, and then we have our editable working files in SVG, EPS, PDF, or PSD. For my illustrations, I generally export them at the size I want in PNG. So we have our PNG preset here, the file format. I'm going to use what's in the document. And all this other stuff is pretty, I haven't changed any of those settings. Those are just default settings there. And if we look in our layers here, there's two eye icons. One is to make the item visible, so the actual lines visible. The one on the left side here is to make the item visible in export. So if we unclick this, it will not export the black lines, it will simply export what we currently see. So this is a way to control what actually exports in the file, and that's helpful if you have, especially have a larger file. Once we're happy with our settings, we can come up here to File and down to Export. Here we're going to make sure that we're still on our PNG setting, and we have a chance to change the file size here. And we're also going to be exporting the whole document. And if we check mark this here, we would don't export layers hidden by export persona. So I'm going to go ahead and just change this file size down to about 1200. Click export, and now I will find the folder I want to place it in and simply name our file. And save. So I've saved this image now with that nice blue and purple background, but if I want to save just the butterfly itself with a transparent background to use as an icon somewhere, while I'm in the export persona, I can simply click the eye on the left here, make item visible and export. So I'll click that off, and now I'm left with just the butterfly itself and no background. So I'm going to come back up to, still with my same PNG settings here, come up to File, Export. I'll change that file size again. Export, and this one will be butterfly vector with no background. And that's it. You've now completed an illustration from sketch to vector in Affinity Designer. Follow me on Twitch for weekly art streams where you can watch my workflow and be able to ask me questions directly. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comments below if you found this video helpful and if you would like to see a more in-depth breakdown of each persona. Keep crushing your goals, and until next time.